Thank you. My name is Erin Moore. I'm here representing Commissioner, Dallas County Commissioner Teresa Daniel. Close enough, says the TCEQ, about their current plan for attaining the EPA standards for air quality. As we say in Texas, close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades. And much like the Department of Homeland Security's now abandoned color-coded threat alerts, we have ozone alerts in the DFW area. The Daily News alerts us because we need to be alerted. Is it a yellow day with a moderate risk, an orange day warning for sensitive populations, a red day where everyone had better stay inside? The residents of Dallas County deserve better. Despite the efforts of the TCEQ, the ozone pollution in the DFW has actually increased from 2014 to 2015, and we have a higher annual smog average than the oil and gas city of Houston. The new study is referenced before by the University of Texas Southwestern Medical Center's Director of Epidemiology, Dr. Robert Haley, establishes a 5 parts per billion reduction in ozone pollution would result in an economic savings of $650 million a year, prevent 100 deaths annually throughout Northeast Texas, including 160 fewer ER visits and admissions to hospitals for respiratory problems, 50,000 days worth of children's outdoor activities curtailed, 40,000 law school days, and $175 million lost dollars and 26 premature deaths in Dallas County alone. The solution is clear. You should require the coal plants to our east to use reasonably available pollution controls as defined in the Federal Clean Air Act, or these coal plants should be included in a larger non-attainment area for North Texas, as it is their pollution drifting our way. The EPA's own review finds the TCEQ SIP to be inadequate. Leading medical experts ask you to reject that plan for health reasons, and Dallas County citizens need you to provide a plan that can meet or exceed the current standards of 75 parts per billion. Only attainment should be considered close enough. Thank you.